वेलकम टू नागेश करसगी और किड्स स्कूल चैनल। आई एम प्रिसिला असादे। आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू इंग्लिश ग्रामर। स्टूडेंट्स, स्टिल नाउ व्हाट वी हैव लर्नड इन इंग्लिश ग्रामर? यस, फ्रॉम लेसन नंबर 1 टू लेसन नंबर 5, दैट इज अबाउट सेंटेंसेस। फर्स्ट वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट सेंटेंसेस, देन वी हैव लर्नड हाउ अ सेंटेंस इज डिवाइडेड इंटू टू पार्ट्स, देन वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ सेंटेंसेस। एंड इन दैट काइंड ऑफ सेंटेंसेस हाउ मेनी काइंड वी हैव लर्नड स्टूडेंट्स? Yes, we have learned 4 kinds of sentence, that is statements, interrogative sentence, exclamatory sentences, imperative sentences. And then further we have learned interrogative sentences in detail, and also we have learned about negative sentences. In interrogative sentence, what we have learned, student? Yes, interrogative sentence means when we ask some questions to any of the person with some expected answers. And in negative sentences, what we have learned? Yes, we have learned that in a sentence, whenever the word no or not is there, then we can say that that sentence is a negative sentence. And in each lesson, students, I have taught you some rules and you have to learn the definition too. So, are you excited to learn today what is our new lesson? That is lesson number 6, nouns. Now, in the previous if you say in third standard you have learned something about nouns, can you say what is a noun? Yes, noun is nothing but a name of a person, place, animal and a thing. So still now we have finished with our recap. We will start with our new lesson, that is lesson number 6, nouns. Open with your Fun with Grammar book and you should have pencil along with you, page number 17. With our new lesson, lesson number 6, nouns. So what is our lesson number? Yes, it is lesson number 6, that is nouns, page number 17. As you open your book, just look on the screen also and in your book also. So, shall I start, students? Now, sentences are made up of words, as we have learned that sentences are made up of words and which makes a complete sense. Till here, you understood? Yes. Now, in a sentence, there are some words, yes or no? Yes. So, these words belong to some different classes or groups. Each word we will say in a sentence, they belong to different classes or groups. Now, these classes or groups, what are they called? Parts of speech. Understood till here, students? Yes. What I have told you, that in a sentence, sentences are made up of words. Okay. So, each word belong to some groups. We can say some groups or we can say different classes. And these groups or classes are called parts of speech. Now, here we can see how many parts of speech, what are they? Now, what is part of speech? How many are there? We can see now. There are 8 parts of speech. How many are there? 8 parts of speech. So, what are they? Come on, repeat. Noun, adjective, pronoun, verb, adverb, preposition, conjunction and interjection. So, what is the first one? Yes, first one is noun. Today, which we are going to learn about noun in detail. Now, look at the following pictures. Now, what is this? Yes, this is our school. School is the name of the place. Who is she? This is one girl. Her name is Preeti Sen. So, Preeti Sen is the name of a person. Now, what is this? Yes, this is one animal. Dog is the name of an animal. Now, what is this? Which thing is this? Table. So, now what you have seen over here? You have seen 4 things. What is there? School, person, animal and the thing. So, whatever name is given to them, that is school, Preeti Sen, dog and table, that is the name given to each one. So, that it is called as a noun. Okay, understood till here? So, how we will define that? Yes, how we will define definition? The names of persons, animals, things and places are called nouns. This definition you can find in your book page number 17 in a pink block. Make it a star so that you can highlight it. Yes, again we will repeat. Now what is nouns? Yes, the names of persons, animals, things and places are called nouns. Understood what is noun? Any names of persons, animals, things and places are called nouns. Till here you have understood. Now we are going to solve. Now here, underline the nouns in the following sentences. Now here, what you have to do, page number 17, exercise A. You have to take pencil in your hand and you have to solve along with me each sentence. Are you ready, students? Are you having pencil with you? Pencil plus eraser. I will solve only 5 sentences, 6 to 10 you have to solve. Ready? Okay. So what is the first sentence? Mother baked cakes and biscuit. So what is the answer according to you? Yes, mother. Mother is the name of a person. Cakes, think, and biscuit, thing. So what is the noun over here? Mother, cakes and biscuit. It will take hardly, it will take a second to underline. So students, along with me, you have to complete your book. Page number 17, Fun with Grammar book. Next, give me a cup of tea. Again read this sentence. Give me a cup of tea. Yes, cup and tea. Why? Because these are things. Done? Okay. Third, we get medicines from plants. Again read. Yes, we get medicines from plants. What we are doing over here, students? We are only underlining the nouns in the given sentence. So what do you think? What is a noun over here? Yes, medicines and plants. Next, I have a pet dog. So what is noun over here? Yes, name of an animal, that is dog. Have you done in your book? Okay. We'll move on to the fifth one. New Delhi is the capital of India. Again, I will read. New Delhi is the capital of India. Yes. New Delhi is the name of a place. Yes. Capital and India. Capital is a common name given to the capital of states and India. So New Delhi, capital and India. So understood to students still here? Okay, fine. Now what you have to do, write from 6 to 10. I'll give you 2 minutes. Not 2 minutes, 1 minute is enough only to underline, to recognize the nouns. You have to read the sentence. Whatever noun you have, you will find that you have to underline with the pencil. Don't use pen in your grammar book. Ready? Okay. What is the sixth one? My favorite fruit is mango. I'm not going to tell you the answer. You only underline. Again, I will repeat. My favorite fruit is mango. Okay, done. Next, Jyoti bought 2 books. Yes, Jyoti bought 2 books. Very good. Have you done in your book? 8. The Ganges is a sacred river. Again, I'll repeat, the Ganges is a sacred river. At least you try to find out what is a noun in this. Done? Okay. Ninth, camel is the ship of desert. Yes, camel is the ship of desert. Next, I left my pencil in school. Next, I left my pencil in school. Hope you have done from 6 to 10 you have underlined all the nouns. Now, do you want to check your answer, students, whether you have done it right or not? Okay, now we will see. So, what is the answer? In the first one, my favorite fruit is mango. Fruit and mango. Fruit is the name given to all types of fruits. Mango is specific name given to one of the fruit. 7. Jyoti is the name of a girl. Books name of a things. Ganges is a name of a river, and river is a common noun. 9th, camel is a specific name of an animal. Desert is the name of a place. Yes. 10th one, pencil, it is a thing. School is the name of a place. So, have you done right? Okay, if you have done the way which I have given your answer, so it shows that you have understood what is noun. If anywhere you have done wrong, you can erase and do it correct. Okay, now turn the page to page number 18. What it is there? B, underline the nouns in the following story. Now, students, here beside that paragraph you write HW. Means you have to read that full paragraph after we'll finish our session. You just do that homework. As wherever you find noun, you just underline that. Now we will move on to the C part. What is that? Fill in the blanks with the correct noun from the box below. What is there? Fill in the blanks with the correct nouns from the box given below. Can you see here, students, what is given? Some nouns are given. So what you have to do, you have to read that sentence, okay, and which particular noun you feel that this noun which should come in this sentence, that noun you have to put in that blank. Now what I am going to do over here, can you see that stars, cows, cake, chess, school, water, river, cowboy, boy, ship? Yes. Now as you will read the sentence, I'll just put the number over here, and afterwards you can copy in this blanks. So ready, students? If you also want, you also just put the number, afterwards you can fill in the blanks as there is shortage of time. So what is the first one? The dash was wearing a red hat. So according to you, which noun will come over here? The cowboy. So just write over here one number. So afterwards in your book, you can write like this, cowboy. Now all we will not write, we will only write here numbers on the whatever words is given in the box. Now what is the second one? Yes, is your dash closed today? Now what it is, which noun will come over here according to you? Yes, what is closed today? School. So just put over here school. Understood? So you what you have to do, only you have to put here numbers on this whatever nouns is given in the box. Afterwards you just copy in your blanks. Now what is the third one? Have you seen the dash in the sky? What it is there? Have you seen the dash? Have you seen those twinkling dash in the sky? Now what are twinkling? Yes, we can say stars. So what is the star's number? Third. So right here, 3. Understood? Okay. Again I'll read. Have you seen those twinkling dash in the sky? So what will come over here? Star. So these 3 number stars you have to put it here. Now we'll move on to the fourth one. So what is the fourth one? My favorite game is dash. Now here they have not asked you to write your favorite game, but whatever you can choose it from here, from these nouns, given nouns, that you have to put over here. So which game is mentioned in the box? Yes, my favorite game is chess. So which one we are solving? Fourth one. So right here, 4th. Understood, students? Okay, so we'll move on to the 5th one. That dash is my brother. That dash is my brother. So that boy is my brother. So you'll put on over there 5th number. Understood? Only copy the numbers on the nouns. Afterwards you complete over here. 6th. The dash flows under the bridge. Now what will flow under the bridge, students? Which noun will come over here? Yes, the river. So right over there, 6th number. Done? Okay. Next. Several dash are grazing in the field. Now what will graze in the field according to the nouns given over here? Yes, sheep. So here is sheep. Right here, 7. Several sheep are grazing in the field. They bought a huge dash on my birthday. So what we bring on our birthday, or anyone brings, our parents brings on our birthday? Yes, they bring cakes. So what is the answer over here? Cakes. So which number we are solving? 8. So just put here 8. Ninth. May I drink in class? Now students, what we will drink in class? Obviously we are going to drink water. So where is water? 9th. And the last one is, the dash gives us wool. So 10th is sheep. The dash gives us wool. Okay, we'll just come to the 7th one. Several dash are grazing in the field. So what is the answer over here? Here is 7. Cows. Several cows are grazing in the field. So again, just cancel the 7th one. We have done sheep. So there you write it. For cows, answer is cows, and for 10th is sheep. Now next, what we have to do here? Circle the words that are not nouns. Now, what we are going to do here? 8th one. 18, page number 18, D. Here, what is there? Some group of words are given. And what you have to do? You have to read that group of words. And whichever noun you don't feel, that is, that you have to circle. So, what is the instructions given to us? Circle the words that are not nouns. So, shall we start? Yes. What is the first one? Sing, boy, girl, school and teacher. So, now sing is what? It is a verb. And other boy, girl, school, teachers are noun. So, what we are going to circle? Sing. Second, baby, talk, sheep, moon and star. Baby is noun, okay. Talk is noun, no. It is action, that is a verb. Sheep, moon, star is also a noun. So, what we are going to do? We are going to do the circle to the word which is not a noun. Now, third, books, read, library, shelf and pictures. So, what do you think in this which will not be a noun? Yes, read, as it is also action word. So, this is a verb over here. So, read is not a noun. Fourth, dance, dancer, singer, sari, dress. Now, dance is what? It is a verb. So, this is not a noun. So, we can circle dance. What is dancer? It is a name given to the person, those who are dancing. So, dancer, singer, sari and dress. It is a noun. Now, fifth, giraffe, tall, elephant, ears and tail. These are all names, but tall is not a noun. It is an adjective. So, we are going to circle the tall. So, understood students still here what I have done? Yes, what we have done? We have circled the words that are not nouns. And then the remaining 6 to 10 you have to do. I'll give you 1 minute. Ready? Six, seven, eight, nine, ten. I'll give you 1 minute. Just circle the words which you don't feel is a noun. Now in 6th, sheep, rabbit, grass, grace and field. Again I'll repeat, sheep, rabbit, grass, grace and field. Seven, pens, happily, pencil, bag, box. See children, whichever you feel that is a noun, you keep it that. But the one which you feel that is not a noun, that you have to circle it. Next, eighth, mango, sweet, oranges, apples and banana. Ninth, short, air, water, cloud, rain. Hardly it will take a second to circle the word. Do it fast. 10th, hair, eyes, nose, cry, name. Done. Now students, do you want to check your answers whether you have done it right or no? Yes. And if it is wrong, just erase it fast and do it. Sheep, rabbit, grass, grace and field. So, grace is an action word. Next, pens, happily, pencil, bag, box. It is a adverb, not a noun. Mango, sweet, oranges, apples, banana. It is an adjective. Short, air, water, cloud, rain. This is also an adjective. Hair, eyes, nose, cry, nail. So,
cry. It is an action word.
Done? Done the way which I have shown you like this? Okay, if it is right, okay. Now we'll move on to the E part. Now what is there in E? Just read the instructions. Okay, so what is there? Find nouns from the word grid using the clues given below. In your book like this, grid is given. Okay. So what you have to do, students? Only you have to find the, see, can you see the bold words? This is a hints given to you. Now you have to read this, a large animal. So according to you, what is a large animal? Just see all the bold words and just see horizontal also and vertically also. So what is a large animal? Elephant. E-L-E-P-H-A-N-T. That you have to write over here. So this will also be a homework for you. Now it is made of wood and we keep things on it. So what is made up of wood? See all the bold letters. Yes, T, table. So just see horizontal, T-A-B-L-E. We read it. Yes, we read books like this. So what you have to do? You have to take the help of that group grid and you have to see the bold letters. She takes care of us, our mother. Red food, apple. Gives us light, sun. Someone who teaches us, teacher. So now I have given you answer also. You have to do in your book. Now, can you say who am I? I cut hair. Who am I? Barber. Come on, write fast. Now we have come to the F part. Done? Okay. See students, what you have to do, already two letters have been given in bold. Okay? So only you have to fill the remaining words. So the one who cut the hair, what that person is called? They are called barber. Done? Be fast. I fly aeroplanes. Who am I? Yes, who fly aeroplanes? Pilot. So only three words you have to write. I O T O P I L O T. Done? Okay. Third, I catch fish. Now who is the person who catch fish? Yes, he is a fisherman. So do you know the spelling of fisherman? If you know, write it. Very good. Come on, copy it fast. I act. Who acts? Yes, actor acts. So what will be the spelling? A-C-T-O-R. Fifth, I sell food items. Those who sell food items, to them what we call? Yes, they are called grocers. G-R-O-C-E-R. So these words is asking, who am I? Sixth, the one who mends taps and pipes. Yes. If there is any work of taps and pipes, repairing work, who do it? Yes, plumber. Come on, write in your book first. Only words you have to copy down and that also in capital letter. I sell flower. Now the one who sell flower is called? Name is given to them. Yes or no? Florist. F-L-O-R-I-S-T. See, in your book, three words are already given in caps. The remaining words, you have to fill it. Now, eighth. I mend shoes. the one who repairs the shoes or who stitches the shoes, they are called cobbler. Done? Yes. So till here, have you done, students? Okay. So now we have finished with our lesson number 6. We have finished exercise A. B, I have told you to do as a homework. Read the full paragraph slowly, and wherever you find nouns, there you have to underline that. See what we have done? On the top, some nouns are given. Yes or no? On that, we have written numbers. That whatever number is there, according to that, you write in your that blanks. Okay? In D, we have done the circle. For example, I have done. I have told you to do the 6 to 10, and also have shown you the answers. Now in E part, what we have done, students? Yes, I have only read it fast and I have showed you what is there. So in that hint is given, in that grid, what hint is given? Some bold letters are given in pink color. Yes or no? H, T, M, E, that are the hint given. And there are some sentences. For example, a large animal is called an elephant. So all the 8 sentences you have to read, and you should take the help of that grid. And in that grid, you have to first see the bold letter which is in pink, which will help you to find out the answer. And F we have solved over here. I hope you have finished all the things which I have told you, and don't keep your books incomplete. So student, which lesson we have learned today? We have learned about nouns. What is noun? Noun is nothing but it is the name of a person, place, animals and things. So just go through the full lesson, complete everything and learn the definition. Thank you. Have a good day.